In this tutorial, we are going to change a color photo into a beautiful watercolor portrait. If you want to follow along, you can find the download links for the images in the video description. Go to File, Open, and open the image. We will use the standard brushes in GIMP, so there is no need to download other brushes. Click on the zoom icon in the top right corner to maximize the image in the window. The size of this image is 1920 by 1280 pixels. When you use an image with a different size, you might want to adjust some of the given values in this tutorial. Double-click on the name and change it to Base. Now we make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl Shift plus D on our keyboard. Again, double-click on the name and rename it Blur. Then we go to Filters in the menu bar, click Blur and then Selective Gaussian Blur. Move the dialog box to the top of your screen, place the cursor on the corner, and when it changes in a double diagonal arrow, we can pull out the dialog box. Move the image in the preview pane. We change the blur radius to 15 and we make the delta 65. Go ahead and click OK. Select the base layer. Press Ctrl Shift D to make a duplicate. Double-click on the name and rename it Lines. Then we hit the green upwards pointing arrow to place this layer on top of the layer stack. Go to the menu bar and click Filters again. This time we hit Edge Detect and then Neon. Move the dialog box to the top of the screen and drag out the window. Make the image good visible. Make the radius 3 and the amount 0.06. Then click OK. Now we hit Colors and click Invert. Back to Colors and now Desaturate. Check the option Luminosity and click OK. Again to Colors and now we click Brightness and Contrast. Make the brightness minus 10 and the contrast plus 40. Then click OK. Make its blend mode multiply. Activate the blur layer. Then we hit Ctrl Shift D to make a duplicate of this layer. Double-click on the name and type in Brushes. Go to Colors and click Invert. Then we change its blend mode to Dodge. Hit the P key on your keyboard to make the paintbrush active. Change the opacity to 10. Choose Brush Acrylic 1. And make its size somewhere around 700. Now brush with big strokes over the entire image, but leave the edges free, like shown in the video. And give the face a bit extra. Change the brush to Texture Hose 03. Make its opacity 50. And the size about 400. Now click on Dynamics. Scroll down and activate the option Track Direction. This makes our brush rotate automatically when we use it. Now we click carefully in the image to apply this effect. When we want to undo one or more previous steps, we can hit Ctrl Z one or more times. When we click several times on the same spot without moving the mouse, the effect becomes stronger. Besides just clicking, we can also click and drag our brush. When we think it's enough, we change our brush to Splats 01 and make its opacity 75. Then we can click some splats here and there. When we feel it's okay, we go to File and open its layers. Here we open our watercolor texture. Hit the upwards pointing arrow to place this layer on top of the layer stack. We make its blend mode multiply and reduce the opacity to about 60. And there we have it, a beautiful watercolor portrait using only the standard brushes in GIMP. I hope you have fun with this workshop, and if that's the case, please give it thumbs up, subscribe and leave a nice comment to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.